let you know,
the seafood will be
all
right.
Radio at the moment. You know, down by the... Yeah, just... So, before I take off, remind me to take my iPad, the number one, and then when you get in, plug your radio.
They're working fine, which is good news. So look at the top of the balloon, you see a big circle, that's the plug I was telling you about. Just making sure that it's working.
See you later.
There we go, guys.
Lovely. Quick, isn't it?
Yeah, cameras at the ready, straight across the crescent.
Oh, look at the city.
Oh, that's true.
Bye-bye!
Bye!
Bye!
Going straight across the city, absolutely gorgeous.
Oh, shit.
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Oh. I think he's just pointing at something. I thought he was waving.
Paragon.
Over the Paragon, yep. Straight over the bell by looks of it.
Oh, can we stop quickly?
Yeah. Big cider. There's the bell, look.
Yeah, there's the bell. Down there. Lower down the road.
Walk on the street. So Vic, up over the university out towards some Melbourne direction.
Roger, have a great sight.
Thank you, have a good retrieve, see you next time.
How high are we?
We're currently 1500 feet above sea level.
1500 feet.
There's basketball going
on. Oh, my ears have just popped.
That conversation already?
Yeah. I don't see any.
Where's the white horse?
That smells coming all the way up here.
Thank you.
I've often wondered.
A jealous landowner. They should open it up. They should open it up, really. Oh, there's someone in there.
I'll tell you a little story now. So back in 1780,
Goldfield Brothers, you might have heard of them, paper manufacturers, built the first balloon, flew out into the French countryside, and it's probable that the farmers at the time probably thought it was aliens invading, so they decided they would hang a bottle of champagne from the bottom of the basket just to prove that they were human. But clearly, being French, they wouldn't have wasted that champagne. They would have brought it on board to celebrate their fight. So in true time and tradition, I think you should be doing the same. So I got a bottle of champagne, two bottles of champagne, one for each side, orange juice, you can have one or the other, I'll mix the two and have a Buck's Fizz. I'm going to pass the bottle to each end. Now, pass it amongst you, don't fill up the first one and not leave enough for the last one, because these cups are a bit big for what we need. So share it around, be nice to each other.
There we go, Charlie. Retrieve my debit.
Yeah,
it's happening.
That's gonna have mine.
Yeah, yeah. We're just on track to go north of Atworth over Larkrise.
Okay, copy that, thank you.
Over here is Neston Park, just in there, this big house amongst the trees over there. Anyone see Larkrise Candleford when it was on?
Yeah, that's what I was just thinking of when you
that's
said Larkrise.
That's where it was filmed over there.
That's exactly what I was thinking
so of. That was Larkrise. No, Larkrise was the farm over there. That's Neston Park.
Oh, thinking.
Thinking about it when you're down, she was an extra in it. Series, Larkrise to Candleford.
My cat doesn't like blues.
There you
go.
There we
go. Come on.
Yeah, don't move. They won't. There you go.
Maybe there's some maybe.
Look at that, we're getting right amongst them.
It's another house.
Notice of all the animals that everybody always sees, nobody says, oh look, there's a cow. We say that about every animal except cows. Even horses. Even here.
Romeo Charlie, what do you think?
Go ahead, Mike.
Just north of Atworth right now, how are you doing?
I'm at Holt.
Holt?
Oh, I thought you were at home.
Why are you at Holt?
Ahead of you.
Oh.
Not really. I'm going to be north of Atworth, probably on the road going directly north from Whitley towards Gastard.
Okay,
I.e. nowhere near Holt. So guys, have I got all the empty cups now?
Think
any
so.
More cups to collect in?
There's loads in there.
Mm.
So all of a sudden there's one there, right?
That's a house. That's another house.
Yeah, loads of them.
This I never realised. Those
oh my
good
gosh.
Way to count the wildlife from hot
and
air balloons.
A rabbit. That one's a rabbit.
Yeah, that's the rabbit.
Yeah. Well, there's ducks or something over there. In that field.
Ducks. Yeah.
Yeah, look, running along that field on the edge of the field.
Oh, pheasant or not?
But, oh, I can't tell. I'm too high.
Somewhere where it's going to cause the least amount of disturbance, and then we always go and see the farmer after we've landed. And generally we give him a bottle of whiskey. Sometimes he wants some money, sometimes he wants to come flying. So go and have a little chat, and get permission to drive in, pick up the balloon.
Someone sitting in a field.
avoid that field.
It's a nice farmer actually. He's the Virgin Balloon keeps his balloon down in the farm over there. So.
Come in, Vicky. Come in, Vicky.
Nice going.
Sorry, go ahead. It looks like he's down in a field to our right, to our left. Full left.
Negative, Simon. I would have let you know if I was landing.
Roger, okay.
But right, run in front of us.
Can't really see them, can you?
No, they're right in front of us.
I should paint them orange or put little things on them.
Oh, yeah, Charlie might have
been. What town is it?
I think that's Chippenham.
Hi, Mike, go ahead.
Possible landing just ahead of me. I'm just going over these wires and then descending.
3353.
Can't see you. Against the trees.
Actually, no, I don't think I will get down in here.
Charlie might be a bit possibility halfway farm on the A350 from just north of Beanacre.
Hey Roger, thank you.
Yeah,
because there was a big lake there. Sewage.
So guys, by the time we get to the end of this field, please have all your cameras, phones, etc. away. Yeah. Nothing around your necks. Let's see where we go. Should we go to the building?
Even the corn looks cold, doesn't it?
Sweet bigs. Will be. Yeah.